All right, now back to serious matters. Joining us now is the great friend of the show, Newsweek opinion editor Batya Ungar-Sargon. Batya, thanks so much for joining us just hours after this incredible verdict in the hush money case. First of all, what is your reaction to this case, how it came down, and how the jury went guilty on 34 felonies that seem to have been spun out of a single misdemeanor?
Thank you so much for having me, James. If I tell you my initial reaction, you'll never have me back because I should really have my journalist card revoked. I was shocked. I was certain that the jury could see through this nonsense. I mean, there were two lawyers on the jury. I was completely, completely convinced that when they said that they had a verdict, it was going to be to acquit him on all counts. And so I'm deeply ashamed of that, of having so misread this Manhattan jury. I mean, I guess I was still in the mindset of sort of the Trump in the Bronx rally, where you really had this amazing reaction to him from locals. But I guess this was just a very different type of New Yorker.
Well, yeah, and I mean, this brings up another question. It ties into something we've spoken a lot about. How much of this case and the verdict of it, you know, this is basically, it all goes back to that 2016 election, which the left lost their minds over and are still obviously not over. How much of this is kind of a revolt of the elites against ordinary Americans?
Oh, it's entirely that. And, you know, people on the right tend to think that, you know, this is all coordinated. Joe Biden is giving directives to the Justice Department and, you know, to the Russiagate hoax and here and there, and that it's all sort of coming from the top. The truth is actually much more sinister, which is that each of these people, each of these district attorneys and judges and people in the deep state and people in professional jobs have main character syndrome coupled with elite class solidarity. And that is what you're really seeing here. Alvin Bragg is a perfect example of this. Nobody told him to do that, I don't think. I just don't think that that happened, because I don't think that that was necessary, James. And the truth is actually much more dangerous for our country, which is that there are all of these self-appointed little Eichmanns, you know, sitting there thinking that it is their job to personally rid this country of the person who represents the working class, because it is a revolt of the working class against the elites. That's what Donald Trump represents. And so you have all of these people who are behaving in a coordinated, zombified way against him, but it comes down to class solidarity of the elites against the everyman.
Well, this is a fascinating thing too, because before the verdict came down, we saw this amazing scene where Robert De Niro, you know, who's played a lot of everyman characters, but is filthy, stinking rich, he launched a tirade against Donald Trump outside the hush money court this week. Have a look at this.
Donald Trump wants to destroy not only the city, but the country, and eventually he could destroy the world.
I mean, this is this level of hysteria, A, that he's going to destroy the world, but B, why is it that the Democrats and the left, somebody said this to me earlier this week, they said, why do they always go for celebrities? It feels like they're really talking down to ordinary Americans when they do this.
It's so amazing, because the trajectory of that Robert De Niro appearance was the trajectory of the Democrats, right? He starts out acting like he is the hero of the everyman, when in fact he is unbelievably wealthy. He then proceeds to lecture them that they should choose his preferred candidate, and that the preferred candidate of the American working class is a danger to this country, when the truth is, it's a danger to him and his wealth. And then when they don't like it, right, there were all of these New Yorkers yelling at him and honking their horns and fighting with him. He then just descends into screaming and name calling and finally just starts saying F you, F you, F you, which is, of course, what the Democrats have done, right? They started out pretending to be the champions of labor, right? They then oversaw this massive class divide and massive income inequality to where they became the party of the rich and the educated and abandoned the working class. And when the working class refused to simply take it lying down and found a champion for themselves in Donald Trump, the Democrats called them deplorables, basically cursed them out, said, screw you, right? We're going to take him down by any means necessary.